In case you're wondering, yes, morticians live in the funeral home. While some modern-day funeral homes are commercial buildings only, many still double as homes for the owner and their family. There are several reasons for this arrangement. Keep watching. 24-hour access. When a loved one dies, the family often wants the body removed right away. They're often in a state of panic or extreme grief and need to be able to make one call and have someone get to them as fast as possible. If a funeral director or staff member is on site, they can get to the deceased much faster than if they needed to get up, get dressed, drive to the funeral home, pick up their removal vehicle, and then head over to the deceased's location. The extra 30 minutes or hour that being in the funeral home when the call comes in might save can mean the world to the deceased person's family. Security. Believe it or not, some drug users actually use embalming fluid to get high. Having the funeral homeowner or an employee live on site reduces the chances someone will break into the funeral home to steal chemicals. There's also the chance vandals could break in and do damage to the funeral home's interior. Since there's typically a lot of expensive equipment, caskets, floral arrangements, and other important items in the funeral home, this extra security is important. Comfort. Many families also feel more comfortable knowing their loved one's body isn't alone in an empty building while they're waiting for the funeral and burial. The idea of holding a funeral in a grand home rather than a sterile commercial building is far more appealing for many families. This is likely a holdover from past times when funerals were actually held in the deceased's home. When a loved one's body is brought into a funeral home where a family actually lives, there's a much more personal touch that many people find comforting. Convenience. When you're on call around the clock, it's simply more convenient to live on site. Since funeral homes are typically very large, particularly the old Victorian-style funeral homes, popular in many areas of the US, there's usually plenty of space for an entire family to live in the upstairs area. In almost all cases, the embalming and body prep will take place in the basement. The funeral services are held on the first floor and the family lives on the second story. Some modern funeral homes don't have living quarters inside, but still have a small apartment attached where the owner or staff live. This helps to ensure there's always someone responsible on site. Finances. Many funeral homes are small, family-run operations. In some cases, it just makes more sense financially to make the best use of the space and use it for living quarters as well. Many employees enjoy the convenience of not having to commute to work and the cost savings of living rent-free. This ends up being a win-win for everyone involved and may help funeral home owners recruit and retain top-notch staff members who are more likely to remain incredibly loyal. Finding a compassionate and affordable funeral home can help make things a bit easier. At Green Cremation, we're here to guide you through every step of planning environmentally sustainable funeral services. Does Melissa live in the funeral home? No. In case you haven't noticed, we are not a traditional funeral home. We do things much more eco-friendly and efficient. We also offer 100% online service, so you don't have to go through the extra stress of visiting a funeral home in person. Contact us today to learn more. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.